What's going on, Tomb Raiders? Draco Invictus here with another Let's Play of Rise of the Tomb Raider. We are working our way through the Croft Manor DLC, and we discovered the secret message on the blank piece of folded paper, and it appears that it is another combination. Does everyone remember the number? I do. Where do we go next? We go to that little flashing marker right there. That's where we go next. So it looks like we're going back to this. Nope. Yep. Am I heading the right way? Yep. Just not far enough. Or it's upstairs or downstairs. Because I am not seeing anything here. So we're running this way. Hope everyone's having a great day. I am having a fabulous day myself. And back into the darkness we go. Well, there you go. Well, shit, didn't see that door there before. Okay, what are we doing back down here? Not seeing anything on the map. Nope, nothing. Solve the mystery of the blank letter. That's not anything. Can't imagine we gotta go back through all that again. Maybe we missed something. Maybe the secret to the Croft Manor is a bottle of wine. Okay, seriously. Still not getting outside.
The Croft family crest.
Hmm. Wow. I love how the chair spins. Huh. Okay. So not in here. Let's go in here. Maybe it's in a book. Dad, what are you doing? You're killing me here. Not checking out the fireplace again. Okay. I guess we head back down here. The little arrow was originally pointing. That's funny, I didn't notice that the first time. Side section. Nope. Okay, this is just bizarre. Take a look at our map again. Nothing. Hmm. Using the object requires the crowbar. So where the hell's the crowbar? Got a shovel. Shovel won't work. At least that stays open now. So where the hell's the crowbar? Wish I had my gear with me. Let's head back over to, I guess, the West Wing. Or maybe we need Lancelot's sword again. No, let's start with the West Wing first. There's nothing over here. What a very peculiar puzzle. And the fact that it gives you no more information. That's the part. It's like, nope, you gotta figure this shit out on your own. Okay. Okay, we look down that way. This is... Give me a sword. We just spent, what, 10 minutes running around? Well, the whole video, actually. We haven't moved very much further ahead than when we started. That chest is open. Dad, you're a bastard. Oh, I've been through the house. Wait a second. Back down to the wine cellar, but not go through. Now that we know that we're looking for a crowbar, maybe it wouldn't show us that before. You would think with all these crates of wine that there would be a crowbar around here. That's my thinking. Aha!
Just to keep his research safe.
Holy henna, Dad.
The renovations are proceeding in secret. The work crew Roth hired for the job have been paid handsomely to keep the details of the job out of the records, so I'm fairly confident no word will get out about what I'm doing. I've been careless with presenting my findings, attracting all the wrong sorts of attention. Roth thinks I'm being paranoid by building this secret vault, but I know I'm being watched. My work is too important and potentially too dangerous. It can't fall into the wrong hands. I need a secure place to keep it all safe.
Just because you're paranoid doesn't mean that they're not watching, right?
The missing page from the renovation plans. They didn't want anyone outside the family knowing about this crypt. Might be able to use this to access other parts of the manor.
Look what I found.
There's an inscription. This is the Croft universe. Our knowledge is to the east. Our respite to the west. Our future is to the south. Our past is to the north.
Wow, I think we'll have to remember that at some point.
Our past to the north. Could there be something else beneath the manor?
I'd say so. But let's finish cleaning out this room first, huh?
Dad's collected knowledge. There must be so many secrets hidden in here.
Richard, I tried to see you in person last week, but your manservant hustled me away like some common tout peddling silverware. He told me you are heartbroken and you're not yet ready to see visitors. He told me you blame yourself for your loss. Well, to that, I say you had damn well better. I hope it hurts. I hope every moment of your life from this day forward is a ringing echo of loss. I hope you live just long enough to feel that pain grow when you hoped it would diminish, because you earned it. You stole Amelia from us. You ruined her reputation and poisoned her mind with a fantasy for children. In the end, you might as well have choked the life from her with your own hands. Do not contact me again, ever. But you must make arrangements for the future of your daughter. Have you considered perhaps it would be better if you followed Amelia sooner rather than later? As Lara's legal guardian, perhaps I could erase some of the damage you've already done to the poor girl. If not, I will do everything in my power to see to it that the Croft name is forgotten. Lara deserves better than you. So did Amelia. And so do we all. Atlas.
Wow.
This was part of a set of statues Dad found in China. He thought it was linked to the Temple of Xian. Perhaps I should look into it someday.
Oh? Are we going to China in the next Tomb Raider? Maybe that's where she's going in the movie. I don't know.
It's over. I have done all that I could, and my Amelia is still cold and dead. Roth first scowled at my designs. Then he pleaded with me not to go through with the ritual. Not because he feared it might work, but because he feared what I might do when it failed. And it has failed. There is no doubt in that. I prepared everything according to my research. When I dropped the stone into the elixir and held it to her lips, I thought for the barest moment that it had worked. The hour was midnight and my pocket watch stopped inexplicably. There was a charge in the air like the moment before a lightning strike. For a heartbeat, I imagined that my life was being drawn from me, as one empties a glass in order to be poured back into Amelia. I would have welcomed death if the last thing I saw were her eyes, clear and alive again. But the moment passed. Amelia is still dead, and I was no Orpheus. We will return to the manor and lay her to rest. I owe her that much.
You brought her home. She's here, somewhere. Dad's Tibetan scroll. I remember he used to pore over this late into the night.
I'm not seeing anything else lighting up, but the lighting in this room sucks. So. Mom's in this cabinet?
Hi, Dad. So I know I only just returned to school, but when can I come out to the dig site again? It's just so boring here. We're doing all the stuff I already read last summer. I always end up staring out the window and thinking about our expeditions, and then I'm yelled at for daydreaming. I promise I'll be good and not disturb you and just work wherever you tell me. I just miss it, Dad. And I miss you.
Ah, I was doing that drifting thing again. Okay, so we need to come back this way. Oops, wrong button. I don't think this is the right way to go. Because I am pretty much right where... Yeah. Maybe I need to be up a level? Because it's not distinguishing the levels of the house. I know where I need to go.
To the east, our respite to the west. Our future is to the south, our past is to the north.
Okay, well, we know that's the west wing. Oh, and now Cortana wants to dance. What?
I
go away. Oh my god. Okay, so we want to go to the south, right?
Incredible. This crypt was here all along.
I expected a sort of crushing finality to grip me when we returned to the manor to lay Amelia to rest. Indeed, Once the last of my funereal duties were performed, I fully believed that I would crumple to the ground next to her and expire, not from grief, but succumbing to the terrible exhaustion of the last few weeks. Instead, as the mausoleum stone slid into place, I felt a sort of peace and energy. One that, I confess, caught me entirely off guard. This was not the terminus of our story, and I was a fool to think so. Her body may be gone, but her spirit still resides here, in the manor, in me, in Lara. Her soul is forever twined with mine, and death is just a momentary interruption. I walked out of that cold quiet into a sunlight that burned my eyes, and I have never been more sure. Death is not the end, and there is work yet to do.
Alrighty. So we don't need to stop and see everyone that's interred here.
My God, can it be? Dad, you did bring her home.
My dearest Lara, it is difficult to write this, knowing these may only ever be words on a page to you. I wonder if you will remember my voice. Will you remember the way we used to play and laugh? Will you remember me comforting you when you were sad? Know that I'm still with you, Lara. My energy, my love. It's within you. It always will be. Use that energy to pursue your passions in life. Never let others determine your journey. You become who you are through your choices, through the love you give and the promises you keep. I hope you are happy, that you are loved and successful in whatever it is you choose to do. I am proud of you, my darling. Remember me with all my love, your mother.
What's this? A letter.
Lara, I have received the notarized affidavit confirming Amelia's grave and the discovery of the burial crypt within the manor premises. While I can't fathom why your father would hide your mother's fate from her own family, I cannot deny that any legal claims I may have had on the estate are now null and void. Croft Manor and the remainder of your father's assets are now yours in perpetuity to do with as you wish. If there comes a time when you require assistance in managing the estate, I hope you will consider contacting me to retain my services. Sincerely, your uncle.
Screw you! Hell no!
I've been so focused on defying my uncle, of fighting to keep his hands off this manor, that I never realized how much this place actually means to me. But since I've been here, I can feel the presence of my mother and father. I sense the entire history of my family and the deep roots we have in this place. I want to honor my parents. I want to honor all of my ancestors. The Croft family may be all but destroyed, but I will make our name and our home great again.
So now it goes into build mode where I can, like, renovate the manor. That would be awesome! Alright, so, I guess that's it. I mean, I'm missing a couple relics and a couple documents, but there's no more story. We finished up the story. So, this is going to be the wrap-up for our Let's Play of Rise of the Tomb Raider. I'm not going to trouble you guys with being the completionist. I already heard loud and clear, don't be the completionist. Okay, so, well, I like this because we got the, we finally understand, you know, where her mom is because she didn't know. So, I like that. I like that we're finally, done. And, we already know what happened to her dad. And, so yeah, now Laura's story can begin anew again with a movie next year. See, look, there I am drifting. I wasn't even touching my controller. Stupid game. Yeah, it's walking on its own. Stupid controller. Yep, isn't that crazy? I'm turning her, but she's walking. Yeah. I'm trying to hold out until November when I get the Xbox One X, and then I will have a new controller. And I'm broke because, well, I'm without job. So there is that. But no, I've been trying to hold out, but I may have to go buy a used one or something. So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed this Let's Play of Rise of the Tomb Raider. And let me know what you thought of the game down in the comment section below. Any questions, comments, kicks, complaints, you know I'm more than happy to answer. And until next time, Tomb Raiders, you take care of yourselves out there. This is Draco Invictus saying this has been the greatest day in my life. See ya.